Good afternoon, everybody. I am Priya Madhavi, working as assistant professor in S&H department of mathematics in St. Martin's Engineering College. So, in BTech first year, first semester, linear algebra and calculus, in that, I'm going to teach one of the topic, that is mean value theorems. So, we have so many mean value theorems here. There are three mean value theorems according to the chapter. One is Rolle's theorem, second one is Lagrange's mean value theorem, and the third one is Cauchy's mean value theorem. Okay, today I am going to explain about Cauchy's mean value theorem. So our topic name is what? Cauchy's mean value theorem. So the main heading is mean value theorem. Cauchy's mean value theorem. So the statement of Cauchy's mean value theorem, it states that statement f of x, let f of x comma g of x be any two real value functions such that f of x and g of x are continuous in closed interval a b, f of x comma g of x are derivable in open interval a b, g dash of x is not equal to 0 for every x belongs to open interval a b. Then there exists at least one point c belongs to open interval a b such that f dash of c by g dash of c equivalent to f of b minus f of a by g of b minus g of a. So the statement is, first let f of x comma g of x be any two functions such that first condition, f of x comma g of x are continuous in closed interval a comma b, and the second condition is f of x comma g of x are derivable in open interval a comma b. The third condition is g dash of x is not equal to 0 for every x belongs to open interval a comma b. If f g satisfies these three conditions, then there exists at least one point c belongs to open interval AB such that f dash of c by g dash of c equivalent to f of b minus f of a by g of b minus g of a. So which is called Cauchy's mean value theorem. So once again I repeat Cauchy's mean value theorem statement. That is, if f, g are any two functions of such that f, comma g, that is f of x, comma g of x are continuous in closed interval a b, f of x, comma g of x are derivable in open interval a b, g dash of x is not equal to 0 in open interval, x belongs to open interval a, comma b. So, if f, g satisfies these three conditions, then Cauchy's mean value theorem is applicable. So therefore there exists at least one point in this open interval AB C that is called such that f dash of C by g dash of C value is equivalent to f of B minus f of A by g of B minus g of A. So this is about Cauchy's mean value theorem. Now coming to problems based on Cauchy's mean value theorem. So let us discuss about the problems. Number 1. Find c 15 में आ रही हूँ 13 में. For the function c of x is given as root x, g of x is given as 1 by root x in closed interval a comma b. Okay, now solution. So what are the given functions here? Given functions are f of x is root x, g of x is equal to 1 by root x. So obviously f and g are continuous functions. Automatically f, g are derivable in the given interval. So therefore I can write directly f comma g, that is f of x comma g of x, here f of x comma g of x are continuous functions on closed interval a b. Also f g are derivable on open interval a comma b. Set two conditions are satisfied. Now I am going to find out what is f of x, f dash of x, and what is g dash of x. So let us take f dash of x means for differentiation of f of x with respect to x, that is differentiation of root x value is equal to 1 by 2 root x. Next, g dash of x can be written as d by dx of 1 by root x, which is minus 1 by 2x root x, or we can also represent it as minus 1 by 2 x to the power of 3 by 2, which is, so by using differentiation of x power n formula, which is n into x power n minus 1. So d by dx of x to the power minus 1 by 2, that is 1 by root x can be written as minus 1 by 2. We get here minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into x to the power of minus 1 by 2 minus 1, which is x to the power of minus 1 by 2 x to the power of minus 3 by 2. X to the power of minus 3 by 2 can be written as x root x. So in this way you can find out the value of g dash of x. So here g dash of x is not equal to 0. Here g dash of x is not equal to 0 for every x belongs to open interval a comma b. So therefore the three conditions of Cauchy's mean value theorem are satisfied. Therefore Cauchy's mean value theorem is applicable. So if it is applicable, then there exists at least one point C belongs to open interval AB such that. So what is the Cauchy's mean value theorem states? If G satisfies three conditions, there exists at least one point C belongs to open interval A comma B such that f dash of c by g dash of c equal to f of p minus f of a by g of b minus g of a. Let us denote equation number 1. Now find the values of f dash of c. So we have already f dash of x value. Now I am writing f dash of c value is 1 by 2 root c. Similarly f dash of f of b value and f of a value. What will be f of b? B is equal to f of b is equal to root b. F of a is root a. Similarly, find out g dash of c value. G dash of c, we have g dash of x value equal to minus 1 by 2x root x. So g dash of c value minus 1 by 2c root c. And also g of b is 1 by root b. Okay, g of a is 1 by root a. Now, substituting these values in equation number 1, substitute all above values in equation number 1, we get that is f dash of c by equation 1 becomes f dash of c value is 1 by 2 root c. By g dash of c value is minus 1 by 2 c root c is equivalent to f of b value is root b minus f of a value is root a by g of b minus g of a means 1 by root b minus 1 by root a. So calculating this we get 1 by 2 root c into 2 c root c by minus 2 c root c by 1 is equal to root b minus root a by root a minus root b by root a b. So finally root c gets cancelled, 2 2 gets cancelled. Here it remains minus c value is equal to root b minus root a by root b minus root a. Negative sign I am applying by writing root a minus root b as root b minus root a into root a b. So here you can cancel this term root b minus root a in numerator as well as in denominator. So we get a minus minus, so the minus minus sign also gets cancelled. C value can be written as root a b. So therefore C value you got, we got as root a b. So which is belongs to open interval a comma b. So therefore for the given question, find C of Cauchy's mean value theorem, f of x equal to root x, g of x equal to 1 by root x in open interval a b. To find out the C value for any question, first of all using the in theorem Cauchy's mean value theorem, first we have to satisfy the three conditions of Cauchy's mean value theorem. First one is f of x comma g of x are continuous functions in closed interval a b. F of x comma g of x are derivable on open interval a b. And also we have to satisfy the third condition as g dash of x not equal to 0 for every x belongs to open interval a b. So for that we need how many values? F dash of x value, g dash of x value, also f of b, f of a, g of b, g of a, f dash of c, g dash of c values. If the two functions satisfy these three conditions, then there exists at least one point c belongs to open interval a b such that f dash of c by g dash of c value becomes f of b minus f of a by g of b minus g of a. So substitute all these values in equation number 1. If the equation 1 becomes f dash of c value is 1 by root c, g dash of c is minus 1 by root c root c, and again by adding this part, if we can apply all those values, we get minus c is equal to minus root a b. Finally c is equal to root a b. So therefore the Cauchy's mean value theorem, by Cauchy's mean value theorem, c is equal to root a b for the given question. So this is about the first question. And coming to the second one, let me discuss about the next question. So finally, what is Cauchy's mean value theorem? Cauchy's mean value theorem is nothing but let f of x comma g of x be any two functions, then first condition is f of x comma g of x are continuous functions in closed interval a b. F of x comma g of x are derivable on open interval a b. G dash of x is not equal to 0 for every x belongs to open interval a b. By Cauchy's mean value theorem, there exists at least one point C belongs to open interval AB such that f dash of C by g dash of C value equal to f of B minus f of A by g g of B minus g of B. So this is about the problem based on Cauchy's mean value theorem. So in this way, we can find out the C value by using Cauchy's mean value theorem. Thank you.